my sir, if you don't have a car behind you. I believe they have repaved this since the last time I was on it. So the bad news is we lose that spectacular scenery, but the good news is we get a bike lane. Belafonte, I think that's the winery slash vineyard. Part where they had to carve the road out of this hillside is always fun, especially if there are not cars coming right up behind you, because we will more or less lose this bike lane. It gets narrow and a lot of debris falls down from these hills, although looks pretty clean today. Champagne Lake RV Resort. This is old 395, but it's also named Champagne Road Boulevard something. And the reason is Lawrence Welk used to own all this land. For anybody under 60, Lawrence Welk was a hugely popular band leader in the first half of the last century. Yeah, I really only know who he is because when I would visit my grandmother when I was a kid, that was a show she would always watch. That and Hee Haw. Lived in Hiawassee, Georgia. I'm sure Hee Haw got great ratings in Hiawassee, Georgia. One time, what was the first presidential campaign she remembered? It was the one where Al Smith was running. She said, they say he kissed the Pope's toe. I think he was the first Catholic to run for office. We're talking back in the 20s or 30s. He was a popular mayor of New York, I believe, or maybe governor. And I don't think a Catholic tried running again until Kennedy. Oh, the venue's looking pretty. I shouldn't, but let's pull over and give you a look at it. Somebody disagree with my choice to pull over right there? They built two brick pillars behind those two very tall palm trees. I'm not sure why. It looks like it should have a street running in between it, but it does not. This tree, even though it replaces the minimal bike path that we get, which this is not really a bike path, just a little space between the edge of the lane and the edge of the pavement. But my motto here in the country is, I'll call it a bike lane if you will. Still had about 23% left on the battery, but I figured I'd go ahead and change it out. If I were going straight back to the car, I think I could make it, but I think I'll do a little bonus ride here at the end and do the always charming little Gopher Canyon Road. Gopher Canyon Road I did once. Declared it a death trap and I won't do it again. It's very curvy with no bike lane, which I've been on this whole time, but it's also a very busy road. Getting folks over from old 395 to 76. Virgin Island Road always amuses me. There are no islands around here, so maybe they have virgins. Loose Gravel, I saw them open for Mott the Hoople once. Noticed that enormous carving of a horse before. Well, I guess the carving's not enormous. Carving of an enormous horse, probably more accurate. West Lilac Road was the road we went up on. We've done basically a big loop. So this used to be a golf course. It must be a floodplain because they're not building housing on it. They're going to turn it into a big park. Hopefully with some nice bike lanes. So this is where we would turn if I was heading straight back to the car, but we'll head down to Little Gopher Canyon Road and do that and then come back.